Hi, this is Kyle from APS, and I'm here to show you how to take wire measurements on sailboat rigging, whether it's shroud, forestay, backstay, short wire assemblies, the correct way from bearing surface to bearing surface. Okay, to properly measure any rigging, whether it's lifeline, standing rigging, it needs to be done off of the boat. But the first part of this has to be done on the boat. You want to make sure that your shrouds, forestay, backstay, but shrouds are set to your medium air or your everyday setting. So while they're on the boat, make sure that they are exactly where you like them the majority of the time. If it's lifelines, make sure that your lifelines are taut and that are adjusted nice and snug. And now what we need to do in order to take these off and reproduce this the exact length that you've created, we need to mark these because we're going to have to take these assemblies apart to get them off the boat, out of the rig. So there's three ways basically to do it. The most basic, get some rigging tape, and before you start to take this apart, take the set screw and move it back down here, and the edge of this will be right where I'm going to set the turnbuckle to when I've uninstalled it off the boat and I screw it back in. I'm going to take it right to that point. This is kind of my least favorite way to do it. The other way, if these are not coated in lanolin and don't have oil or anything on them, in some cases, usually with smaller boats, you can take a Sharpie and go all the way around this, and you're going to have to push the Sharpie down into the grooves. If the rigging's wet, this is not an option. And I can see the black there, and that's where I'm going to take my rigging to when I put it all back together. The best way to do this is to get a set of calipers. You've got everything set to where you want it, and all you have to do is put your caliper against the body and bring it down here to where the thread ends and make sure that you write this down. And where are you going to write this down? Well, most importantly is before you take it off the boat, you need to put a piece of tape on here. Duct tape's great when you're using a Sharpie. Mark it port starboard, and then put this measurement in place. The other thing you want to make sure is don't assume that your turnbuckles were set exactly the same. It could be that somebody, when they were installing the mast the last time, screwed this on a little bit farther than they did this, and when they anchored it, this one's out more than this one is. You need to make sure that these are equal on both sides before you take them out. This is a lifeline fitting. This would be set the same way. This is almost impossible, as you can see, to get tape. It's a little bit tough to get the Sharpie in there, but you can tell where the threads end, and I can certainly get my caliper in there, and I can take a measurement, however small, and write it down. Same thing if you've got a single stud assembly. All you need to do is set it on the boat. While it's in the boat, just take your calipers and take that measurement and write it down. And this is like a backstay adjuster on something like a J22. Same thing. Just take that measurement, write it down. So that's how to prep on the boat. Okay, we're just about ready to start measuring. But measuring to what point? Commonly referred to as the center point by a lot of people, but that's really an imaginary place because we can't physically hook something to it and measure from that point, nor can in some swage machines can they be pulled through from a center point. So what we measure to is the bearing surface, and that's this surface here. If this turnbuckle was under load and holding a rig up, all of the tension would be against this surface. So at home, you'd grab a screwdriver and your trusty assistant would push the screwdriver through, and this now becomes the exact same as that bearing surface. And we would hook our tape to that. And so the bearing point of the fitting is also the bearing point of our tape measure. And then we would just pull this under tension, run down to the other end, and take our measurement. Now here at APS, because we do this so often, we've got our rigging benches all set up with a fixed point for bigger rigging, smaller pieces like this. And you'll notice that with our tape measure down here in the table. Here's our starting point on the measuring tape. That matches this line, that also matches this surface right here. So I put the bearing surface against that post. That matches up with my tape measure, and I can just run down our bench and take a measurement right from the tape. Okay, now we're off the boat. I've got the turnbuckle completely taken apart, and here's the tag that I put on it using white duct tape while we're still on the boat. This is labeled port or starboard. This is port. This is an upper shroud, and the distance on the thread that I measured with my calipers was 9/16. So now I've got to get this put back together while I'm on shore off the boat to the exact same adjustment that it was set to on the boat. So you notice I'm making sure that this doesn't rotate, and they go in evenly. And cue music here as I go. Yeah, I think I'm getting pretty close here. I've already preset my calipers to the 9/16. I'm just going to put the brake on so it can't go anywhere. And that's basically what I'm looking to achieve. I'm a little bit shy there, so I'm going to keep going. All right. And that's pretty much right on. Being off one thread or something isn't going to be the end of the world, but we try and be exact at every point here. Now, really important that we've got this set and that it stays in this setting. So make sure that you go ahead and repin everything so that you're moving around. These don't start to untwirl. So whether it's this, you do it with a single thread, you've got it set. In this case, we would lock it down with the lock nut very securely, and we'd be ready to start our measurements. Okay, I just want to make sure that we're really clear what the bearing surface is. This is the starting point for our tape measure that's built into our bench, and you can see that line carries over. This area right here, that's the bearing surface that matches up with our measurement point, our starting point. And this area where it's bearing against that post is the bearing surface of the hardware. So that's where I start my measurement. And I'll show you in a couple other examples. Let's see, let me pull this. Here's a pretty big T-terminal. And basically this goes into the mast, and the shroud, that's where all the load against the mast is, and that's where we're gonna measure from. We're gonna hold this right up against that and run down and do our measurement. Other instances, here's just a hand-swaged eye, and again, this is where all the load is on this piece of rigging, is right here. That's where we start our measurement from. About a fork eye, here's one. So the pin is out of this fork eye, and when this is under load, right here is our bearing surface where we start our measurement from. Okay, so a couple of curveballs, if you will. If you're just measuring a piece of rigging to the end of its threaded stud, its swage stud, the bearing surface is measured all the way to the last thread. So I would match this thread with that line, with that right here to here, and that's what we're measuring. We're not measuring this area here because it's not helping us in the linkage in the rigging. Now here's another left fielder. This is an assembly for a dinghy halyard, a main halyard. And we've got a swaged on, machine swaged ball here that holds the shackle in place. And then we've got these two that would go into a halyard lock that would take all of the load of the sail. So if we wanted to measure the overall length of this, here's the exception. When you're dealing with wire fittings that have shackles on the end, this is the one time that you actually keep the pin in. So in this case, we're measuring right against the pin, and that's our bearing surface, and we could run down the length of this and do the overall. Now, the measurement of where these go is between this bearing surface, where the sail bears against, the head of the sail bears against the shackle, and where the halyard lock the claw, if you will, makes contact, and that's right here as it starts to go round. So my measurement is, let's see here, just shy of 5 inches between here and the bearing surface here. And then my lighter air ball stop is down here, and I would measure between the bearing surface and the bearing surface, and that's going to come in just a hair over 7 1/4. Now you know how to measure wire rigging like a pro. For more how-tos on rigging, splicing, and wire assemblies, visit us at apsltd.com.